Okay, let me show you how Caret can allow you to create decision trees in a nutshell. So basically, let's run again this Titanic dataset. And if you remember, we have different features. Some of them are not very interesting, like the index, the name of the passenger, and the sex code. So we're going to do a couple of things. First of all, I'm going to choose the target category, the survive, and only these three features. Now I'm going to rename the contents, the levels of the survive category. Instead of using 0 and 1, I'm going to use died and survive. So I'm going to use this function if else. And again, remember that if you want to play with categorical variables, you have to use the factor function. So let's convert this to factor, again with the class and with the sex. So here we go. So we have 1,313 observations, three features, and one categorical variable for the target. But if you run the summary, you see that we have a lot of NAs. So in another video, I showed you how to remove them. Today, basically, the only thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remove all the categories. Instead of imputing some values to the to these NAs, I'm going to remove them. Okay. Now let's set the seed. This is just if you want to replicate the results. And now we're going to train using this data frame. I'm going to use the target variable survive. I'm going to take only 80% of the data of the rows for training and 20% for testing. I'm going to use cross-validation. And again, if you run this, we don't need to pre-process. And this is one good thing about decision trees. Is part of the interpretability of the methods is related to the fact that we don't need to manipulate those features. So basically here I'm saying, okay, try to fit survive versus anything else using the training data set. I'm going to use decision tree using the algorithm R part. I'm going to use this control for cross-validation. Remember, tenfold cross-validation. And I'm going to test 13 values of the parameter. You can use this by hand using this CP. But here, basically, I'm allowing cross-validation to try 30 different values and let me what's the best result. So let's run this fit. And now let's make some predictions. This is the confusion matrix. Accuracy is not, it's not impressive, but it's not bad. Okay, this is the chosen one. So this is the one, the complexity parameter that maximizes the accuracy. Remember that you can define different metrics. Like if you want to maximize a kappa, you have to include this line, like metric equals kappa. Okay, you can play with that. And again, if I plot the fitting, basically what I have is a summary of the outcome of the cross-validation. So here you can see the accuracy is maximized for this value. But if I want to plot the outcome, so I can use this final model. Okay, not the fit itself, but within the fit object, I'm going to plot the final model. So this is not very informative. You can add some text here. And again, it depends on the size of your plot. So let's plot this again. But this is not very beautiful. So there is this beautiful library called rpart.plot. So load this variable, and now you can see something that is much more beautiful than that. If you add this parameter, fall leaves equals false, then you see this in a traditional branch way. So let's make some interpretations from here. So basically, this box tells you that, forget about the label here, this tells you a 41% survive. Remember that our category is 0 means died and 1 means survive. So this number is the probability of survive, okay? So 41% survive only. And now every time we have this bifurcation in the tree, yes is means that we are going to the left and no to the right. So if sex male is equals 1, basically this means that if yes you are male, then you go for this side of the branch. And if male is not 1, meaning that you're a female, then you go for this side of the branch. Okay, so let's analyze this part first. And now, again, forget about the label. So 20% of male died. Okay, and now the second branch comes here. So basically, if H is larger than 3.5, and remember, this is confusing, but basically this means that yes is going to the left. So yes, you are above 3.5 years, then the chances that you survive is only 17%. And if you are a baby, a child, meaning that your age is lower than 3.5, then remember, no is to the right. The right side of the branch, meaning that 93% survive. Okay, now let's analyze the other side of the branch. If you are not a male, meaning that you're a female, then second question, If third class equals 1, yes, then go to the left. Only 44% survive. And if third class if you're not in third class, meaning that you're in first, second class, then 92% survive. So this gives us a good interpretation of what happened with the Titanic data frame. Basically, the chances of surviving are pretty low if you're a male. And if you're a male, only if you're a baby, you could survive. Okay, and if you're a female, if you're not in third class, your chances of surviving are pretty high. Okay, so this is a good summary of everything that happened with the Titanic data frame. Remember that the thing that I love about decision trees is interpretability. So taking a little care of what's the meaning of these boxes, you can do this and you can explain this to a client or to a buddy or whatever.